Thank you, Moreno. Monty's running for the United States Senate.
Good morning, ladies and gentlemen.
Good morning.
Republican leaders, that's who you are. You are guiding and directing this ship called the Republican Party in the state of Minnesota, and I will be working for your endorsement and I hope I can earn your trust. I grew up in the inner city of St. Paul. I grew up between the McDonough Housing Projects, the Mount Airy Projects, and arguably the poorest neighborhood in St. Paul. Out of the poorest neighborhood, we are the poorest family. Out of the poorest family, I was like the youngest. I was 7 out of 8 kids. With 8 kids, mom, dad, those 10 of us lived in a 2-bedroom, about 850 square foot house. Our house burned down when I was 10, parents were divorced when I was 11, and I moved to a place called White Bear Lake, Minnesota. I eventually graduated from this high school we were in. Dennis Dunnigan was sitting in the front seat, and I used to slide down these things that where the stairs are now. I think we're beyond the point where we can be prosecuted for that. And Slater's gotten a little bit of trouble growing up in the city with fighting and things like that. That was part of what he did when I moved out to White Bear Lake. Got in some trouble for fighting and with the police, and I asked them, would you consider opening a boxing club? And they opened up the White Bear Boxing Club, which is still in existence today. So I became, from a street fighter, became a boxer, and then became a Golden Glove boxer and became a Golden Glove boxing champion. That being said, it takes a lot of guts to stand in a ring. And the people that I fought were a lot bigger, a lot meaner, and a lot uglier. They chew on your ear, okay? And then Al Franken is. But Al Franken needs it to go down. Today, after living here in White Bear Lake, my wife and I now live in Marina on St. Croix. I've been a small business owner for about 25 years. And the reason I'm running for this seat is because I'm sick and tired of what I see going on in Washington and in the state of Minnesota. If you like the way things are going in Washington and in Minnesota right now, there's something that we need to do as conservatives to take our country and our state back. And I'm going to give you one element of it. About 7% of the people in Minnesota are Latinos. Have you looked at my last name? Moreno. That being said, I grew up on the west side. My first boxing club, I thought it was the Mexican American Club. I grew up right by Richard Aguilar, if any of you know who he is. The Latinos are hardworking people, industrious people. They pay their taxes, and there's some illegals in Minnesota. Mark Dayton did something in the last session that allows illegals now to vote. He gave them the ability to get a driver's license. Are you aware of that? So now with the driver's license, they can vote. Now we have one chance. We do not get a do-over. We have one chance, and one chance only, to bring these Latinos to the Republican Party, to make us as Republicans the majority in this state for a long time. We don't get a do-over. Now either we bring them here, or the Democrats turn them into an impoverished bunch of people and turn them into victims, and we become the minority. Who wants to be the minority? Raise your hand. I didn't think so. So one great way to do it is bring on a guy named Moreno. Because if you have a name like Moreno, and these people are from Mexico, and they come up here and they're gonna vote, and they look at Franken or Moreno, who do you think they're gonna vote for? Okay, I mean, it doesn't take rocket science to figure out. Because we have more in common with Latinos than the Democratic Party does. They're hardworking, they're industrious, they're family-oriented, they're Christians for the most part. So we need to bring these people to the party, and I'm just the man to do it. And that 7% is the difference of victory or defeat. That 7% is the difference of us having everything that's being shoved down our throat right now continue for the next 20, 30 years for your children and grandchildren, or we turn back the tide now. The National Republican Party recognizes this. Who are the two most prominent U.S. senators in Washington? I would contend with you it's Marco Rubio and Ted Cruz. Why? Because they're both Latinos. Because the Republican Party understands there's 12 to 14 million illegals in America, and they need to bring them to the Republican Party, or we nationally will be a minority and have the things going on that are going on in Washington right now for the next couple of decades. Now that's only one aspect of my platform. You have a piece of paper in front of you, a yellow piece of paper that looks like this with 10 issues on it. You can go to our website, montymoreno.com, and you can see where I stand on a lot of other issues. Now, you can see speeches on each one of those issues as well. I am a strong supporter of Israel. Al Franken needs to be defeated. and you put me in a room to debate Al Franken, trust me, I will not be intimidated. I will not back off. We will go after this man, and we will take him down. This man's voted against your Second Amendment rights, and I will stand up for your rights, and I'll stand up for the Constitution of the United States of America. I want to thank you for your time. I hope you have a great convention. Again, my name is Monty Marino. I look forward to your endorsement. God bless you. God bless America. Thank you much, Mr. Elliott.